Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Allison Cruz, and as the dawn of a new day approaches, welcome back to Fallout 3, where we are made our way to the National Guard Depot on complete accident. I don't think I have ever been here, but by complete happenstance, after the mockery that was the disappointment of the Myrler treasure caves, we're gonna come in here for hopes that maybe, just maybe, we might be able to get something good. So let's do it. Now, I'm gonna assume that a place called the National Guard Depot, that this is gonna house some pretty sweet things. Not gonna lie, it sounds like it might have a couple of WMDs of mass destruction, so let's hope that we can hopefully obligate our purses as well as our wallets and pockets with things that are actually worth it, not just seminal amounts of ammo. I don't know. Seems like a weird waste to me. Oh, and also I did drop off all of my stuff back at our apartment in Megaton, so don't really have to worry about that. About carrying things, at least not for 150 pounds worth of stuff, so we will go ahead and just continue forward, venture with relative haste. Ooh, okay, there are robots in here. Not surprised. Uh-oh. Excuse me. I'm not a bad guy. Quick, dog meat, turn him off. Does he have missiles? I mean, you always see them with missiles. Okay. Is this seriously? Turn him off, dog meat. I'm distracting him. Oh, there we go. That's what I wanted to do. Whew. Okay, he's off. He's been dealt with. Box. Okay, so I'm assuming there's many sentry bots. That's not good. And, ooh, there's some things here. This bottle cap mine I will take. Also, lots of radiation. Alright. Oh, it's a good puppy dog meat. Alright, so it looks like there are many different ways that we can take here. Do we want to go downstairs? I'm assuming to continue forward, we have to go up. And, ooh, there's a thing over here. Maybe this will give me a little bit of insight on what I have to do. Oh, turrets. Just kidding. Of course it's gonna be turrets. And the first one again! That's kind of awesome. Alright, deactivate turret systems. Okay, so we're on the bottom floor now. Might as well just whoop this guy. This little Protectron buddy. Whew. Alright, here. Kill you. Just shut you off with the flip of a switch. Ooh, there's a cell here. They kept prisoners of war straight up in their offices. Interesting. We can sleep here. Maybe just a little bit. Are you good, dog meat? Ooh, also I forgot to mention this. When I was back in Megaton, I dropped all my stuff off, but I realized my shotgun is almost dead. It is in piss poor condition, so that is not good. However, I did equip mini pulse grenades, because those might turn out to be good business for us. Because they're, oh my god, they're very good against unsuspecting foes, such as that Mr. Gutsy. And it does a shit ton of damage. Also, we have a bunch, so. Whoa! Tell my family I love them! Ooh, things are exploding. Not good. Alright, there we go. We have so many pulse things that we never use, so I figured it might have been in our best interest to do that. But it doesn't seem like it's doing that much damage. Do you know if pulse grenades actually are attributed by, what are those called? By your explosive rank or whatever? Ooh, this looks like a storage closet for the ages. Let's see what we got. It's a little bright. Oh, hey, Nikola Tesla on you. Nice. Already worth it. Oh, and that's energy weapons, I think, right? So you always gotta think Nikola Tesla, electricity, it's good stuff. Uh-oh. Shit, there's somebody up there. That's no good. Ooh, there's a bunker over here. Large bunker, a utility door. Can we even lockpick it? No, we can't. Why are you telling me you need a very hard lock? Ooh, okay, so a couple episodes ago, I was telling you, like, these types of doors, these, like, barricaded ones that are, quote-unquote, activated somewhere else, somebody was telling me you can actually open them by tricking out the camera a little bit and going in the third person. I don't know if it'll work for this one, but basically you get the command to open it, and that's assuming the electrical switch is on the other side. And just for a brief moment, you will see it pop up, the prompt to open the door. Now, it depends on if there's actually a switch on the other side, which means this might be its own room, and we will need to activate it somewhere else, but it's usually at eye level, or near it. So, and it's just kind of a funny thing. I don't know. Maybe you're supposed to look at it backwards. And that's right. We haven't explored enough of this. I'm assuming this is the final area they want us to go to. Unless we have to destroy this. I don't think so, though. Because whenever have we had to do that? Never, really, right? So we'll continue forward. Alright, that's enough for the first floor. Can I get back up here? Yes, I can. Excellent. We will go upstairs and phase through things. I was not meaning to do that. Nice little hangout spot for the crew, for the gang. Oh, man. Ham radio. Is there any cool things over here? Seems very high-tech and also in high contrast to these pieces of shit Windows DOS runners. Oh god, there's a thing right there. Oh, is this the one that we murdered? Oh, I think it is. I don't know. Pulse grenades don't seem like they're doing a fantastic job of killing things. And of course it's gonna miss. Was that really a sneak attack though? Could you really construe that as such? Oh, and I can't even aim at it. Okay, the way he throws grenades is so bizarre. Changes very frequently. That one seemed like it missed, so you know what, sir? Ugh. Oh, I'm so sorry. There we go. And do you have missiles? He does. Missiles from the scraps of his ashes. Good stuff. Good stuff indeed. Alright, we were just over there, so let's head upstairs. Can we go this way? Oh, I guess we can. Just completely walked past it. Didn't even realize. Alright, so torched books. Don't need those. Oh man. Some random ass helicopters over there. Are you kidding me? Can I not jump? Over here. Are you guys ready? God damn it. Lag in this game is horrible. It's not even lag, it's just the frame rate sometimes. What is going on over here? Interesting. Can I even go in there? It seems like, I really would like to. Now I'm stuck between a table. Okay, so we need to go up one more floor. I think I can walk along this area. Oh yeah, see right here, look it. I can touch the fire hose from being on the other side of the door. And that's the same basic concept. It's just activating things through doors and shit. Because why not? Okay, so there are many things over there. Dogmeat seems like he's very preoccupied. Okay. And then more books. More crates. Oh, it's just right over here. That was a jip. Alright. Oof, there's another one right over there. Alright, let's go for it. We'll just take him out. Post haste. Sentrybot, prepare to meet your doom. As long as I don't miss, but. Oof! Oof, critical. Was that even a sneak shot? Another critical, damn. Getting pretty lucky. Up all night to the sun. Up all night for good fun, etc. Alright, he's dead. Hopefully none of his friends heard his cry of terror. Ooh, turrets. Are those the ones we took out? Because sometimes, as we learned in the Vault-Tec headquarters or whatever, that's not always the case. Maybe we need to take these out because they seem hostile? Are you guys good? I should probably still take them out for the experience, so that they don't come back to murder me later. Oof. There we go. And this turret. Oof. I destroyed something. Oh no, they're mad. He's mad. There we go. Ooh. Excellent. Alright, so is that everything? Did we murder everything that deserved to be murdered? Also, there's this. Oh, hey, check it out. What do you know? It's the turret control system right next to the thing. Automated. The automated turret control system. Nope. Finally. This one might be it. Hey, automated. No, it was agreement. I always just see the top one, and I'm like, that's the one. And I'm assuming we have no more turrets to turn off, is that right? There. Just for good measure, to kill them again. What the? Dogmeat? What are you doing? God damn it, Dogmeat. Quit being a straight-up maverick. Don't make me save you. Watch out, Dogmeat! Oh no, Dogmeat! Don't do it! Damn it. I'm grenading my own dog. No, abort! Abort VATS! It is not worth it. No, stop! I should have realized this was going to be a thing. Great. And he's dead. Thanks, dog meat. I don't think I even got any experience for that. Okay, so we can get back up through here. God damn it. That's a lot of experience just to be going to my puppy there. You good, dog meat? You gonna stop antagonizing all the goddamn robots that live here? I hope so, because... oh, man. These guys, they don't deserve what we're giving to them, so... alright, let's see. New cold machine in the cafeteria. Nothing. Nothing but nothing. Alright. So let's move forward. No cool books here. Wait, why do they need two Nuka-Cola machines in the same room? It's like going in your break room and them having like two Pepsi machines. It's like, what the heck is the point, dude? Alright, nothing there. So, we have to go through their cafeteria in order to enter the depot training wing? Really? Alright, I'll take it. Oh, you okay, talk me? You okay there, little buddy? Oh, and we're under caution already. Apparently, even in the offices of the training depot, we've got sentient, bloodthirsty robots trying to kill us. Oh, so welcome to December 13th. Today has been a fairly, hasn't been a super productive day. It's a lazy day off. Also, I have to go to work in 3.5 hours, so that is always fun business. Except not really. Not looking forward to it. But what's kind of cool is my family actually are in the process of seeing Muse right now, which is cool. So really tired, so I was like, probably shouldn't risk it. Probably just wait another day. Because they're, well, I guess they already drove to Portland and they're just waiting to see them now, so. Gives me a little bit of time in the evening to record some stuff that I probably wouldn't have otherwise, so what better thing to do than to excavate the hell out of this place, which apparently has nothing. Are you serious, dog meat? Am I gonna have to send you home? God damn it, dog meat. Alright, no, I will not shoot your butt. I will kill this man for you. So, but that's pretty exciting. Seriously, this is all that's gonna do? There's also somebody on the other side there, so. There. Excellent. Who's over here now? You gonna cool your jets now? Oh, it's just a turret. It's just a turret. There. Oop, that was not good. This turret is a little bit more powerful than I gave it credit for, so you know what? Get yourself a nice little missile launcher treatment. Just gonna wait a moment. Actually, I should just shoot it. I should just shoot it. Not dog meat! Jesus, you can't hit it! You cannot hit it! You are a ground-based creature. This thing is on the ceiling, so I wouldn't try. I want to see if pulse grenades work. It's probably a bad example, but as far as I know, I don't think pulse grenades actually hurt the turrets. And do you see? What a pitiful throw. Dogman's like, he can do it himself. He's like, oh, I just can, you can do it. Okay, so which one is it? It's the left. The left one, there we go. Which didn't take so long to equip things. Okay, we are done. So yeah, I opted out of going just because I didn't really feel like taking a trip to Portland. I had that gig yesterday that actually went pretty well at the Water Resupply Center. And it was interesting. It was much, much more subdued than I thought it would be. It was just like, we played in this like circular rotunda, which is actually very, very nice sounding for the area. And there was just, it was an alternative gift fair, so a lot of people were there. You know, accepting charities and things like that. And that was all cool, and you just played sentient ambient music, and all the songs I had prepared, I was expecting, like, at least a minor crowd or audience? Not the case. Not exactly the case. Oh, there's a turret control system thing here. What in the world? I was not expecting that. Canisters. Personnel. Is it gonna be this one? Nope, it has to be... ignorance. Excellent. The process of... there's only 5 options on there. How could you get it wrong? That's interesting. But yeah, it was pretty fun. The guy who played before me, he was kind of old. He's, oh yeah, I've been performing live for 58 years. Herbiderbiter. And I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. He's like, I've been playing longer than you've been alive, right? I was like, oh yeah, I definitely look like I'm 59 plus years old. So, but it was fun. I played on his acoustic guitar, which was, a plug-in electric, which is different because I've never used one before aside from my Gretsch, but that was different since it's, not acoustic like that. It's still hollow body. That doesn't make it acoustic. So it was interesting and it was fun, just much different. But it was weird because I had to transpose a lot of the songs that I wanted to play from E flat into E, and so it made singing them really awkward. So that I wasn't a big fan of. I didn't want to be awkward and like detune his guitar. Be like, hope this is alright. So some of the songs that I sang sounded kind of shitty just because I'm sitting there trying to find the right key, and yeah. But overall, a lot of people liked it. I got lots of woos and things from all the people. I bet they were pity woos. They pity the woo. Ool. More saves and things here. But overall, it's fun playing gigs. So, even if they're not paying, and they're just for other business. Oh, but the main thing about that I thought was hilarious was this teacher, this second grade teacher, came up to me super excited and was like, do you want to play for my second graders on Wednesday mornings? And I was like, wait, are you serious? Is that a serious thing that you're actually offering me to do? And she's like, yeah, we'd really love to have you. And it's weird because obviously you don't know a lot about me because you probably don't watch a lot of my videos, but somebody described my playing as well as my general aesthetic and feeling for guitar playing as gothic, which is bizarre. Like, of course, like a lot of the songs I ended up having to, they were basically transposed, but I had to play them really low key, and it was just kind of an odd thing, I think. Okay, so is that everything here? We got a pre-war book right there. Not really paying attention to what I'm doing. But it was cool, and I think I might take her up on it, maybe if not just once. Because Wednesday mornings, I always work Tuesday nights, and that kind of sucks, but I'll still be up at that time, guaranteed, because graveyard shifts, so much fun. But yeah, it's gonna be good. We already got this, didn't we? We did. So yeah, that was my Saturday night. It was good. Also, I had worked Friday night going into Saturday, and the gig wasn't until like 2 p.m., so imagine you going to perform an acoustic gig at 2 in the morning, basically, for you. Or I guess it would be closer to like 3 in the morning for you. So my sleep schedule's all messed up, so anyway, let's go over here and have some more business with dealings here. Careful, dog meat. This is a very interesting place. Oh, baby! Yes! Ammo for days. Oh, excellent. Caliber rounds and also assault rifles. I probably won't pick any of these up. Are they in horrible condition? This one would only give me 9 caps if I sold it. Huh, interesting. Oh well, we have some unique stuff that we can take out of our things, because I think we have a unique weapon of every single kind, almost. So I noticed we had like Zhonglong's Chinese assault rifle or something, and other things, and I just would prefer to use those. Alright, so big double doors, let's go into the restrooms first and explore these. These are very strange restrooms. Could you imagine being the loser that would have his lockers in the bathroom? It's like some ladies in there. She's like, occupied. It's like, lady, I really got to get in my locker. There's something I got to pick up. She's like, occupied. Might have to wait a couple minutes, but you can grab it later. Like, that would suck, right? Also, more locked first aid boxes, because why not? So, ooh, also, we're hurting a little bit. Just use that just in case. I didn't even realize. Don't really have to worry about health too much here. And also, stealth boys. Excellent. Excellent business. Alright. Ooh. Uh-oh. This is no good. Dog meat? Would you like to stand back a little bit? There's a mother brain over there. Or robo-brain. Apologies. What do we got over here? Rounds. Ooh. And also this. Okay, I'm gonna be a little bit on the safe side here. Just gonna explore and wait. Oh, there's a couple of them over there. You know what we could do? Okay, so there's at least... Wait, I thought there are 3 of them over there. Damn it. That's a lot. Is there like a turret over here? I don't think this game has those sorts of turrets where you can just like sit on them and then, you know, just wail at them. Oh, and there's a sniper. You know what? We should take that. I was gonna pick one up just for fun, just for shits and gigs, but I forgot. Okay, I'm just gonna throw a couple grenades over there. I should just toss them like way the hell over there, right in the middle of all of them. Oh, and of course it drops off, gets that guy. Oh, jeez. Oh, they're mad. He's mad. From the smoke comes a giant-ass missile. Okay. Let's hope that... There we go. Ooh! Oh, beautiful. Absolutely. Ooh. And last but not least, you're dead. Oh. I missed. Still got the Robo Brain, though. Still got the Robo Brain. Okay, can I even get that one? What about... Not even that one. I can't aim for the Robo Brain, by the way. It's probably because he's in the way. We'll try this. Waste of time! Oof. There we go. It's like, no! Mother! Oh, that's good. There we go. Dogmeat! Be careful, Dogmeat! That guy has taken literally no damage. Okay. Oh, but I killed the Robo Brain on complete accident. Oof. Watch out, Dogmeat! God damn. Oh, there we go. Oh, critical strike on Dogmeat. And how did I get crippled? What crippled me? That was quite unfortunate. Damn it. Okay, so we're good. Might as well clear that up. Where did it say I was crippled? Oh, my head, apparently. That's not good. I don't want a brain full of pesticides. Alright. So this is the training ground. This is where the Marines of the sort, they practice their shooting at just various robotic creatures. It's like, you sons of bitches, you'll never take over this facility. This is America, and we don't take kindly to you, the kind that we create, because we're just racist and we hate everything that is not born, bled, and fucked into America. Also, an insubordinate amount of sandbags. Somebody took an entire day to move a bunch of these bags filled with sand and then just stack them this way for no apparent reason whatsoever. Also, there's a door over here. Why is there a door over here? What purpose would there have to be a door over here? Also, these small rooms that serve... Oof. No. No purpose. God damn it, Dogmeat. Quit moving shit around. You're freaking me out, man. Oh, more things. This isn't even like a closet. Hopefully there's more to this. Some grenades in here. Just keep them right next to the Tupperware. No big deal. No big deal whatsoever. There should be some pretty cool stuff in here, like a bunch of first aid boxes. I'll take those. Thanks so much, sir. Take the stim pack. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, and another locked first aid box. And we opened it! Sweet. God, we're getting a bunch of stim packs. Like, I think we have, like, hundreds at this point. Hundreds, if not millions upon billions. Also, filing cabinets. Why did they put filing cabinets here? They have to walk through the firing range to get back here. It's like, alright, Margie, I need you to go grab a couple of documents from the back there, please. And be like, well, do you really want me to while they're shooting their loads off into sandbags against the wall? Like, just go do it, Margie, I need those fucking files. It's like, okay. Just, like, dodge them and everything. Ah, but... Wait a minute. So you need to go through the firing range to get to the depot offices. I feel like this might be a little counterintuitive for all intents and purposes. I hope you can understand why I feel this way. That's quite alright. Do you think there will be people here too, Dogmeat? How do you think they get through the doors and all of the rubbish that they're crawling over? It makes no sense to me. Uh-oh, making noise. We have alerted the robotic horde. Okay, so over there we've got a Robo Brain and then two turrets. Is there a thing somewhere that we can... Ooh, not good. Okay, Robo Brain. I see them. I will go down the stairs. Except I do not know how to climb stairs. Help. Uh-oh, not good. Here, I'm going to take out those turrets. Take off the turrets. Hopefully Dogmeat doesn't die. And... Well... Lag immensely. Also, we took out something there. Dogmeat! Don't make that noise. Oh my god, Dogmeat, you're a maverick! Oh my god, he's like, no, I will jump! I promise you I will jump! Jesus Christ, Dogmeat, also this guy. This guy does not know what's coming. Don't disturb him, Dogmeat, I got it, I got it. Ooh, ooh, Solid Snake! Oh. There we go. You good, Dogmeat? Here, I'm gonna go take this guy out with my MPLX Nova Surge. That I forgot I had. But I just remembered. There we go. Yo, yo, goop. Yo, goop metal, good sir. Alright, and this Robo Brain that I apparently served no assistance in killing. Now, I think there's supposed to be a... a terminal somewhere that would have turned off that grenade, or that turret, but apparently not. See, overall this place seems very boring, very... droll, nothing to do here, unless I'm just missing something. Just lots of areas. Of course he's got his chalkboard here. Wasn't this like the year like 2070? Like, why do they still have things like that just hanging around? Like, oh yeah, well, still needed that blackboard for our abacus training and things, so why the hell not? Also, there's this. Oh, don't tell me. Oh, it's right here. What the hell? Alright. Yeah, there are not that many things here. Scattered, okay, so we can just literally scattered this one. Yeah, see, it's easy. She loves her sanctuary, so. All right, deactivate, don't really have to. Why are there, and this one is locked, okay. You can see how that could have been difficult with that Robo Brain up there. all right, excellent. So we'll move forward up here through the door of Americans. Because that's where we live, is America, and it's the most supreme country in all the world. I hate all other worlds and countries because, well, they're pieces of shit, and they're un-American, much like this bust of an Indian man from what was formerly known as America. Just kidding. Also, it's Mr. Gutsy. Mr. Gutsy. I'm sorry, you have no idea what you got yourself into. Also, let's see how much pulse grenades do to us. Yes. Die! Damn. Not doing a lot there. Dogmeat, you're taking most of the bullets. Is that another? Ooh, what was that? Oh god, it's Dogmeat. I might need to get rid of him at some point. Just maybe. Oof. Also, I accidentally took out my shotgun. Didn't want to do that. God, I don't know how I keep forgetting what's attached to what. Alright, Dogmeat, you good? Can I go turn him off? Locked on, firing. Do not turn me off. I was just learning how to love. That's right, good friend. Good night. You can love being dead for all I care. Excellent. Okay. Now that everybody that Dogmeat was antagonizing is now dead, we can continue on with our lives. And continue the game. Oh man. So, is this just a really long area, or is it just, like, I don't know, super long? Also, thanks for lagging there, game. let's see, what do we got over here? Why is this place irradiated? Ooh, duck and cover. Duck and cover. We'll take that. Actually, let's smash a couple of books into our face, shall we? Also, I'm sure we could probably get a couple of things. Oh, I have a radiation suit still. It's in broken condition, though, obviously. As well as my hat. How did that work? Interesting. Alright, moving on. Duck and cover, I think, is explosions, right? Yeah. Explosions in the sky. Energy and... Also, I held on to the strange meat pie just to see how sick I would get. And bartering! Excellent. We are becoming more capacitated as time goes on. That's some good business. Alright, and... Man, I'm hoping something cool will show up. Like, getting all of these, like, comics and things are really cool. But I'd also just really like to be able to get some cool shit. Ooh, you did not see me! Dogmeat, you wanna go distract him, get behind him so that I can turn him off? Oh, Jesus Christ, he is charging! He's like, you killed my lover! How dare you! God damn. Dogmeat was ready to pounce. Now he's just like, ah, it's alright. Dogmeat must be traumatized, getting attacked by all these metal creatures in a world that we're living in where everything is mostly metallic. Yeah, it's alright, Dogmeat. Don't you worry. Okay, so this is where he came from, so, ooh, what is this? National Guard. Wait, does this just take us round robin back to where we just were? Damn it. That is really disappointing. What is this? I can shoot that and destroy somebody with it. Damn it. Well, that was a good way to spend the time leading up to my shift at work, which I actually had traded with somebody because, I don't know. Ever since, when you start doing night shifts, like 10 to 7s, like 10 p.m. to 7 a.m., it's really hard to transition to 3 a.m. to 11 a.m. And also, I just don't want to deal with people I've seen there because it's just like, oh, I haven't seen you in so long. It's like, well, yeah, I try to leave so I don't have to deal with any of you bitches. Any of you straight up assholes. God damn. So there was this one day at work. I left quote unquote early, but it wasn't technically early. It was just earlier than before I was supposed to be, but it wasn't like too bad. And ooh, hold on. What is this? Pre-war books. Yes. Excellent. Anything else? That would probably be a good haul. And apparently this lady complained like super hardcore to this other lady, like those regulars, those people who you work with that have been there for like 30 plus years, but you know they're gonna be there for the rest of their life, aka lifers. And it like pissed me off. I was like, what? Why the hell would you like complain about that? It has absolutely no bearing on you whatsoever, and everything got finished, so it's not really an issue for me. All right, let's leave. Actually, do you want to know something that I just remembered, actually? Is that we still need... Oh, wait, this is different, I think. We've been here. This has been some... Wait a minute. Ooh, this is different. Have we not been up here? Oh, no, I recognize this. Oh, yeah, this is the... Okay, so that's the cafeteria down there. And we can drop down, but... First... Okay, so there's no other way to get up here other than from the office depots, right? So, is there something up here that we need? Whoops, just picked up a Nuka-Cola Quantum on accident and I felt myself doing it. There it is! There it is! The breaker! The breaker switch to activate the thing. Is it down somewhere over there? Oh, it's right there! It's right there! It opened! Oh, and then we can drop down there and- Ooh, let's do it. Are you ready, Dogmeat? Our haul, that was actually pretty significantly well done at this point. Get even better? Are you ready? I'm excited for this, but there's a person in there. A sentry bot. We want to take you out. I'm gonna drop down on you Splinter Cell style. Speaking of which, I was thinking of doing Chaos Theory again, giving my hand at doing another project of that. Because I actually, for some reason, that was one of the only projects that I ever deleted all the videos for of a series. And I don't know why I did that. So, there's that. Sir, would you care to die? Here, just gonna murder you, cripple you, and turn you to mush. Oof, the game does a significant number of lag there. Alright, so we're good. Oh, here's the electrical switch. So, you know how sometimes this thing will be right next to the door? That's what I mean by doing that. Oh wait, it's for this thing. Can I just... Oh yeah. There it is. Alright, so this... Oh, are we gonna head inside of their armory? Oh, I'm super excited. Whew, let's do it. Yes, the armory! Oh, yes! Seriously, ooh, this is gonna be good. Is it gonna be guarded, though? I'm just gonna be a little bit careful. Just a tad bit. Just a wee bit careful. Okay, so electrical switch. Let's try this theory. So if it is on the right-hand side, it should be on the right-hand side on the other side of this door. Right there! Did you see it? Right there! Electrical switch. It works! It works! I kind of figured it would, because it makes sense in the context of the broken physics, but holy mother of Jesus, Mary Josephine Christ, oh baby. Oh, you guys. Oh my god, look at this. We will never have to do anything searching for ammo ever again. Also, something loaded. Not sure what it was. More frags. Oh, I'll take these radiation suits, since I already have one. We'll go ahead and heal them up. Yeah, these are in really shitty condition. That's not good. Alright. It's not good to have a bunch of radiation suits with a bunch of holes in them. Oh my god. This is amazing. Also, this combat armor. As tempted as I am to take them, I think we're gonna hold off on that. Got police batons all laid out. It's a very, very unique way of doing things. Oh my god, look at all this purified water. These guys were way ahead of their time. Don't know why I'm taking them, but we really don't need them for anything. Empty syringe, take that, you know, stick it in our mouth a little bit. And, oh, sweet Jesus. So, oh my god, look at this. Look at all these missiles. Oh my god, this is amazing. This makes up for any blunder we may have had discovering something that we thought was gonna be cool. This makes up for literally everything. Oh, Jesus. This is incredible. Oh my god, this place is so beautiful. What's over here? What is over here? I'm assuming that computer has a very hard lock on it, so fingers crossed that it's sometime in the middle of the night so that I can bust it open. Sweet Jesus. How many times have I said that in this part? Oh, it's just a minigun. Oh, I thought it was gonna be cooler. Yeah, we could probably take the minigun. I mean, just it's a token of our adventures here. Apparently I have one stowed away in my locker at home, so. And it's only 18, so, and that should be the last of it. So that's pretty sweet. Ooh, wait, what is it? Oh, pistols. It's like, how did I miss looting that nonsense? There's a bobblehead! Yes! Oh, it's a small guns bobblehead! I don't know what our small guns is at right now. It's probably actually, it probably is almost maxed out, I take it. Small guns. It's at 93. Ooh. But anything that'll upgrade our combat shotgun, and thus the reign of shotgun terror, is good in my book. Oh my god, because it's easier to have courage from a safe distance away. Aww. It's been permanently increased by 10 points. Obviously, it tops out at 100, but still, good to have. Oh, bunker access terminal, and uh-oh. Do I just open it? Is your access code incorrect? Oh no! No, we need an access code! Fuck. Can I just get in there? Do we, or... Dog meat. Are you thinking what I'm thinking? I'm probably getting my hopes up. So we'll see. Can I just cheat? We're at like episode 80 of this series or something. Can we just cheat? Is there something I can touch? Otherwise, this will be a great business for us. Just gonna look around in this corner a little bit, do some Halo bungee ass breaking through walls and shit. Damn it. That's very unfortunate, and are the codes even in this place? Because I'm pretty sure I searched all of the terminals. There's nothing. There's nothing. Nothing to do. Oh, god damn it. This is the worst dog meat. Well, we can't. There's no way that we missed it. Unless, give me just, oh my god, dog meat. Are you trying to, what the fuck just happened to dog meat? I was trying to say something, boy. Where did you go? Oh, there you go. How's it going? Quit dying. God damn it.